Well, hi there, and welcome to our Sunday hymn time. And as you can see, I have a bit of a Christmas motif in the background because I have a song that, well, okay, originally the music isn't exactly about Christmas, even though this song gets sung at this time of year. But you'll recognize it very much. In fact, I mentioned the music because the words you won't recognize at all. A number of years back, my friend Len Habermill was involved in the production of the Christmas Pageant at his church up in Waterloo, Ontario, Canada. And he asked if I might just take a crack at writing some new words to this well-known piece of music. As I say, you'll know it. It's called When a Child is Born. But Len wanted me to focus on one particular child. I hope it blesses you. A single star shining in the east, and on the earth an angel's wish for peace, and across the world dawned a brand new morn. This all because a special child was born. In Jesus Christ was God personified. From Satan's hell there sounds a battle cry, but he gave his life to open heaven's door. And for our sin, a special child was born. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I am the way, the truth, and the life, said Jesus. No one comes to the Father except through me. And John tells us that as many as received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. And in the years since Jesus rose again, there have been millions here who've called him friend. Sinners saved by grace, we sound the victory horn and praise the Lord, a special child was born. And praise the Lord, a special child was born. Very special child. In fact, his birth was a miraculous one. Now, this takes some faith on our part, but I was thinking about, well, the story from Matthew's Gospel. Oh, in fact, if maybe you might want to read as a family the Christmas story right from the Bible, just look at those early parts of Matthew and Luke, both of those Gospels, the first four books of your New Testament, they have the Christmas story in them. And I was thinking about Joseph, you know, a hardworking man and a good man. And he was espoused, he was betrothed to Mary. Now, back in those days and in that culture, an engagement lasted one whole year, and it was as binding as marriage. In other words, the only way to break the engagement was to actually divorce the person you were engaged to. And, well, think about Joseph. He finds out that this woman is expecting a baby, and he knows it isn't his. Now, he has a couple of different options in this society, and neither one is going to work out all that well for Mary. In fact, one of the options will actually mean the end of her life. That's the way it was back then and in that part of the world. And well, let's face it, in a lot of places in the world today, it is still difficult for women. those made in the very same image of God, every much as any man, right? So Joseph, the Bible tells us that he was a righteous man. And so he decided to divorce her quietly because he didn't want to subject her to public shame. Now, after he considered this, Matthew tells us that an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." And all this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us. You know, I was thinking, I guess it was last Sunday now that I think about it, I was sharing those words, you know, from the angels to the shepherds, part of the Christmas story. And remember, the angels talked about that good news. And the angel said that it would be for all the people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior. You know, we think of Christianity maybe as a Western religion, even though it was born in the East, and it certainly has ties to Judaism. But this message of this special child, it's for everyone. It's for the whole world. And John, his gospel, well, he talks very differently about the origins of this one who became flesh, John says. And he calls him the true light. And he says again, it's the light that gives light to everyone. And it was coming into the world. And though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. And in fact, many people, well, especially today, they want nothing to do with Jesus, right? But John says that that word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. Jesus wasn't created, right? He was part of the Trinity, but he was brought forth in that little manger, right? As a baby. And John says we've seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. And in the little narration part of this song, that verse from John chapter 1, it says that as many as received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Yes, a very special child, although you know as well as I do, he didn't stay a child, a baby in the manger. No, he grew up, became a very special man, and he went to a cross. He died, and he rose again so that you and I might have the gift of eternal life. Hey, if you haven't already, let me just invite you to open up the door of your heart to him, to his invitation to come in and give you the gift of eternal life, forgive all your sins. And, well, I tell you, you know, it's been a very difficult year this year, hasn't it? It's going to be a difficult Christmas time. It's still going to be somewhat difficult through a fairly good part of 2021. Now, if you open your heart to Christ, not only will he change your Christmas, he will change your life. And regardless of what you do or don't do, I just want to thank you for watching and spending a little bit of time with me here. And may God richly bless you this holiday season.